Sarah has been working in the financial industry for more than 25 years as a strategy consultant, division and development manager, as well as a partner. Her stations were mid-sized companies, as well as large corporations like DXC. For her, blockchain is not only a pure technology, but also the basis for the future in business, as well as society. Really important point. In this context, she has implemented a wide range of projects and solutions and has been able to put them into production. She'll be helping us get to the bottom of the issue, why 86% of enterprise blockchain implements fail. Please give a welcoming round of applause to Sarah Rentschler-Gerloff.
Thank you very much. Yeah, thanks.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much for the warm welcome. So, a lot of people here. Yeah, we heard now the cryptocurrency and all this stuff, and let us go back a little bit to the reality. What enterprise blockchain implementation fail? Anybody here who has implemented a blockchain or DLT project? Yeah? Is it in production?
Yes, for energy consumption.
Okay, great, great. More?
Yeah, there's a gentleman right here.
Okay, 99% fail, okay. Normally, we know, let us look under the world from the digitalization. WordPress does it for website. I started with this sentence. Also, the Stripe does it for payments. WeSettlement does it for blockchain. I will explain you this sentence why. Only 40% of enterprise blockchain is not moving into production. It comes not from settlement, it comes from Gartner in 2020. This guy said 99%. But why? We have the situation. Let us look on our agile world, Scrum-based design thinking and so on. We start normally with a use case. Use case regarding to different business, to supply chain, to trading, finance, to NFT now, the newest one in the family. Also to digital assets. We heard from tokenization, but what we mean with if we said tokenization? Is it to create a token, or is it to define the business as well? So all these points we clarify in use cases. We move then to the business case, because if I have a use case, then I also need a business to this. I will make money, and the money I make in the business case, not in the pilot or anything else. And so if we look at this, that we can check this, can we prove this, we have pilots. We bring it to the POC stage, to the proof of concept. But I think we are in 2021, we have a lot of proofing of concepts in our branches, in our region. And so if you look at that, and this is also from the researching from Gartner, 9 to 15 months we need that we know we are on the POC. And then, we're on the POC, what does it mean? So the decentralized business and technology, we deliver this, we deploy this in clouds. Google, Amazon, Azure, Orange. But can we also go in production with this cloud provider? If you stay in the financial part, you have to bring your solution, your application to the regulated environment. And what does it mean, a regulated environment? Normally they have his own data center. Here in Germany we have to regulate the BaFin, so the data center should be also regulated based on BaFin. And this step, the most are not successful. Why? Anybody an idea why? First thing we said, we have the coding skill fail. Because blockchain is not new, but it's not old. So if I look back, I developed now software since 1989. And if I see today, I have seen a lot of cascades which coming up, the 4GL, the SQL, the model-driven architecture and all this stuff. But we see the blockchain is a little bit different to centralized-based developing. I need skills which they are also able to think decentralized, distributed, and not only centralized. So it is one of the most issues that we find that the skill what we have is not enough. We have issues. I think let me describe these issues regarding for dirty details. We look on our business in our design thinking workshop. We look on the use cases, but in the most parts, we forget the environment, developing environment, the infrastructure, and something else. At the end, we're stuck in the experiment. Yeah? You're stuck, and you try to elaborate what kind of solution I can have now, and so the costs are running and growing. Let us talk about the skills fails. Are you agree with this? Less than 1% of coders are trained in blockchain. So we have a lot of good developers. So we use them with Java and also, but the blockchain, so we can also blockchain and DLT projects developed in Java, but the other one is in Solidity. So each language has its own, let me say, challenge. You can build an in-house team, so that takes time. And then is the question in which language you will build this team, in Java, in Go, in R, in Solidity, or maybe another one, in Python. So you have to think about it, you have to elaborate it, you need a business strategy. You have dependencies to the customer, to your suppliers and all this stuff. Your partners and to your consortia, which you have to plan to join it, for example. The other part, maybe we can buy external help. We can go to the consulting industry, we can book developers, consulting, advisors, and so on. But then I have the point, I have dependencies. Maybe I don't have dependencies. Yeah. Also, I can talk about the insurer, insource of the shell solution. Or I can talk about, maybe you can buy an application today. So regarding for the blockchain and DLT industry, you have a lot of applications. In the digital asset world, we have a lot of digital asset platform. Why I should develop a new one? In the trading finance world, we have Komgo, we have WeTrade, we have Marco Polo, and a lot of other stuff. Right? So these questions we have to answer if we plan to create a blockchain project or an application. The organizations, we said only 1 in 7 got a chance to have success on their blockchain solution or developing a project. So we see, and this is a fact and this is an experience what I got over more than 6 years now, we see that we lose the competitive from the advantage. And this is definitely a lack of the execution speed. So you stay in your POC and you stay in your design thinking, you have a budget from 12 by 15 weeks and you start. But you don't have not clarified the dirty details. Let us look on this apart, several issues for these dirty details. So maybe you can start and you can create your own infrastructure. It's possible, but you need hardware. You need nodes, you need skills, you need the right providing partner, so maybe a cloud partner. But a lot of companies which they plan to develop a blockchain or DLT project, they don't have DevOps on board, they don't have DevSecOps on board. So I can try this, I can elaborate this, and this is one of the dirty details. If I start with only the focus on the business, on my use case, and then at the first 2 weeks, I come on this point, And I have to question where I can deliver the node, where I got the node, in which kind of infrastructure I can create a node, I must create a node, and I will deploy it. So for this, I need the skills, I need the human resources, and I have to test all these things. We don't have to forget. And we have differences between Google, Azure, and Amazon, big differences. The next point is we have to build the use case. But what does it mean, build a use case? For a digital asset, we have to tokenize them. We have to describe the business. We have to describe the regulatory dependencies, the legal dependencies, and all this stuff. And then we can go forward and can develop the smart contract also to a supply chain case. We have to elaborate and analyze the process, the participants, and all this kind of what we need. So we have to elaborate, we have to code it, we have to audit the smart contract. It takes time, right? And so from the experience what I got is, normally we need this 2 by 4 months. If we do this from scratch, yeah, and then I have the smart contract built, and then comes the question, how can I can deliver this, how can I deploy this, how can I bring this on the chain? Because also here I have differences between the chain protocols. We don't have a standard like SQL. We don't have an interoperability between these chains. And one of the biggest issues what we have regarding to the development in a blockchain project is how I can integrate an existing system. So I know we start with pilots, and normally in the pilot we create mocks based on UI. So we create forms that we can enter our parameters, our data very quickly. But in the daily business, in our reality, we need an automation process. We need the state and information from the backend system, from SAP, from core banking system, from procurement system, a lot of other stuff, especially in the supply chain world. We have a lot of participants, and each participant has his own backend system, which I have to integrate. And the integration of this, we can say, yeah, we have the REST API, but we have different chain protocols, and we have different APIs methods. We have the oracles and so on. We have the flows. This is also then the point of questions regarding the security. How can I onboard this backend system, especially in the finance sector? Every risk operator and manager comes and prove this integration, check the integration path and all the security parameters and so on. In the next one, what we have to build a network of participants. In a central-based world, we build our participants or our network, not based on an organization. So each participant has his own organization. And in a blockchain-based project, they have to orchestrate all these participants together. And this is the reason why we need them, an infrastructure which is the same on every participants, because we stay in a distributed world. We don't have to forget this. A lot of blockchain projects, what I've seen, they deploy all his nodes in one data center, in one environment. So I ask him, is this a distributed business or is this a distributed architecture? And if I have distributed participants, maybe we have 3 data centers which is involved. Each data center has its own rule, has its own governance, and so on. I have to clarify that. I have to identify, and I must convince my participants there. And I will do this very quickly. But identify and convince from the participants, it takes time. We have then to clarify a lot of stuff with the data center. Is it possible to open your port 80, 120, for example? So you discuss this with these guys 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks, 5 months, maybe. It's depend on the size of the data center. It's depend, is this a financial data center or governance data center, and so on. So, and if we look back and we remember us, we planned then a POC or a pilot, normally with 12 by 15 weeks, maybe 20 weeks. So it's a long time for clarification regarding to all them. Also, we have to clarify how we can deploy this. So I must be sure that every participant has deployed his node in the right infrastructure that is working. If I look on all these issues and all this experience, I come back to the sentence, we lose their competitive advantages due to the lack of execution speed. And the point is, if you stay in a pilot phase, for example, we're working on the study details, we lose our point of view for the business. Yeah, so then I try to find solutions. My budget, I have 12 by 15 weeks budget, is running away. At the end, from 12 by 15 weeks, you need 15% of your budget to clarify all this stuff, to find the right cloud provider, to find the right integration strategy, to find the right APA strategy and all this stuff, and then the budget is off. In the end, from the pilot or POC phase, the stakeholder comes and asks you, and now I will see the goals which we have to define and which we have confirmed in our advisory and in our discovery workshop, for example. And you say, oh, sorry, I must clarify all this stuff regarding that I can continue with my development. And then this one of the reasons that the stakeholder said, okay, sorry, then it was the wrong decision. It is not only a story what I tell here, it's the experience what I what I got by myself, right? Blockchain can be very easy. So we have a complicated structure, we have a complicated network, but we have solutions for that, that we can have a very easy, let me say, network infrastructure. Yeah, the complexity, we said, we kill it normally because we have to discuss with everybody this complexity of this technology. Why? 20 years ago, I must nobody explain how the SQL databases is working. Today, we must explain everybody how the blockchain is working and why we need this complexity world and why we have to create a lot of stuff that we can start this blockchain project. I remember in my career, I started with a programming language C, and then the workbenches is coming up. And as a developer, I said, oh, I no need this workbench because I will have my creativity, I will have my freedom and all this stuff. But at the end, I used this workbench because I have seen I was faster and I have to focus on the business and not on the tool which I have to create. I have seen a lot of smart companies, small companies, which they have great tools for every project. You start one project, you create tools to create nodes, to create a deployment and all this stuff. And then the next project is coming in. You have to create, or you have to extend these tools because you have another participant. And they say, okay, now I need it in blue. And after 1-2 years, I have a set on tools which I have to support, but nobody is paying the support for me. And this is one of also from the dirty details. If you look on the budget from a project, the money is running away, yeah? And then at the end, you have zero revenue. Blockchain can also be fast. Sure, why not? We talk about them, they're very slowly and so on. But it is risk-free, we can also say. So if I look back on the sentence what I have presented you, at the moment we have a lot of risk if we start from the scratch with our own developing from tools and from deployment and so on. You have a lot of risk. Why? Because you don't can clarify anything. Otherwise, you have a big team, and then you be expensive in the developing of the projects. This capability is also a very huge theme in our blockchain developing phase. It's not only scalability regarding to technology. This is a big challenge for us, right? Because we have the scalability regarding to our infrastructure, to our Kubernetes, OpenShift, container, and all this stuff. But the scalability regarding for the network, regarding for the participants is another theme, what you have to clarify. So a new member comes in, or a new participant comes in, and then in a world, if you have created by your own, you must give them all this stuff and said, okay, now please install it. And then they take also then again 2, 3, 4, 5 months. And it's too long. A settlement we have created, we call it a low-code platform. So we have created, let me say, all these steps to create a node, to consume a node, to deploy a node, to distribute a node, all this stuff, we have automated. You choose a protocol, you size it, you choose your provider, Google, Azure, Amazon, your own cloud, on-premise. On-premise is a very important point if you stay in the financial industry or in the governance industry. You click it on enter, and then you wait 4, 5 minutes, and the node is ready. I can use it. I can create my consortia. I can invite the members based on an email. I send them, now you are the admin, you are the developer, you are the business analyst. I give them access to different layers there. And then I continue. I said, okay, the node is ready, it's deployed, and then I can also order and choose my tools. We deliver an IDE based on Visual Studio in the browser. We deliver with them more than 240 smart contract templates, which you can use or not, but the smart contract template, they are ready for Go. So for example, a state machine for the subplate chain world is a state machine. So maybe I change my state, or I extend the states what I need. It depends for the participants, for example. Also for the bonds, or for the funds, or for the identity, and all a lot of stuff. Maybe it's not helping for everybody, but it's helped to start very quickly for the people which are not have this knowledge, the deep knowledge regarding to this world. And we have the dependency for the smart contracts regarding to the protocol which you have choose. So you choose Corda, then you got it in Java. You choose Ethereum or Quorum, Hyperledger Base, you got it in Solidity. If you choose the Hyperledger Fabric, you got it in Go. So we lose, we support at the moment a lot of chain protocols. And then with the IDE, with the smart contracts, you can start. And then we also deliver a migration layer. With this migration layer, we visualize the smart contract. That means if I create a smart contract, I have parameters, input parameters that a smart contract can run. We represent the business logic from our tokenization part, for example, from the use case or business case. And then I will test the smart contract very quickly. With the migration layer, I can enter the parameters based on a, let me say, small formula, and I can create the token, I can mine the token on the chain. And then I can also continue, and I can continue with a graph interface, which represents the business logic based as a tree, as an action tree, as a logic tree. You can click through this, and you can sit with your business analyst, you can analyze this, is this right or not. So this is very helpful because the business analysts, normally they have no developing knowledge. And at the last, we integrate the backend system, we use an open source tool based on Node-RED. So you can integrate the core banking system, SAP, also a simple email client. It is like a painting world, so it's like UML or another modeling framework. You drag and drop your client into the dashboard and your parameters, and that's all. And at the REST, we create for all this the REST APIs that we can integrate the off-chain world as we described, the world which they don't have direct interaction with the chain at this point, the settlements, the custody worlds, and a lot of other stuff there. And this is helping to reduce the risk to create dirty details and to bring forward the speed, what we have described, what we have confirmed in our analysis and discovery workshop. And we will do this and develop this in this time period, which we have also confirmed in the pilot phase, for example, the 12 by 15 month. And then we have a chance to have the speed, and we have to focus on the business and the use case and not on the environment. This is, from my point of view, a very helping tool, what we have created.
Excellent. Give a round of applause and a thank you to Zara Rentschler-Gerloff, please.
Thank you very much.
Last chance. 2021.